when I'm dating somebody and then we reach that point and they fart in front of me first, I'm like, oh, thank God. I'm so glad it was you first.
Yes.
Welcome to Broadly Hotline. I'm Bunny Michael, overflowing with advice and inspiration to help solve all of your issues. This week's topic is relationships. Here to help me answer some of your romance questions is millennial sex and love expert Eileen Kelly. Eileen started her blog, Killer and a Sweet Thing, when she was just 16 years old. And now she has hundreds of thousands of followers who are engaging with her on everything we weren't supposed to talk about, but we desperately need to know. Hi, Eileen, welcome. Yay.
Thanks so much for having me.
So are you ready to answer some of the voicemails that people sent in about relationship issues?
Yes, absolutely, can't wait.
Okay, let's listen to our first voicemail.
I've been seeing this guy for 3 months now. We're not dating, there are no labels. The only issue is that he won't go out in public with me. And he works crazy hours, so I believe him when he says he's too tired, but it's getting to the point where I'm frustrated and I want more.
Oh my goodness. Okay, well, first off, you deserve like someone who respects you enough to be seen in public with you.
You don't need to be a boyfriend, girlfriend to go out on a date,
yeah.
Right? So people go out on dates all the time and they haven't even met each other before. And I also wanna say, you are in a relationship, okay? I know you guys aren't calling it that. The real issue here is that you're afraid to communicate.
Maybe he doesn't even know that you wanna leave the house because you've never brought it up to him.
Totally.
So I think you can kind of dive into it slowly and suggest a date, plan ahead.
And it doesn't have to be this like, we need to talk thing.
Yeah.
That can be really like triggering for people.
To get your needs met, you have to lay out your needs.
I also want to point out, he's totally laying out his needs. Mm-hmm. He's saying, hey, I want to stay in because I'm tired. But is he too tired to fool around? I mean, is he too tired to make out? Like, that takes energy too. Mm-hmm. Maybe don't hang out with him until he's had his rest. Maybe he needs to have a nap and then you guys can go out.
So I found balloon fetish porn on my boyfriend's computer and I'm wondering if I should bring it up to him, let it go, or do I bring balloons into the equation?
Ooh, I definitely don't think you should just start bringing balloons into the bedroom. I feel like that feels like a boundary overstep.
Right.
That you saw this on the computer and then all of a sudden it's like you can read their minds. The first step maybe would be to have a conversation with your partner and just casually be like, hey, do you have any fetishes? Or what are some things we can spice up our sex life with? Or what kind of porn do you watch on your own? And allow your partner to tell you.
And I'll be one to say first off that sometimes the things you like to watch in pornography, you actually don't want to experience in real life. And just making sure you let your partner know that you would never shame them for any of their sexual desires. But yeah, I would just like to say, don't look at your partner's internet search history, okay?
When is it okay to start farting in front of your boyfriend? Is it ever okay? Does it affect intimacy? I don't know. Might be different for everyone.
If I'm about to hook up with you and you're like farting a lot, like it's going to affect the intimacy of that moment and yeah. Maybe turn me off.
It is definitely okay to fart in front of anybody. Now, does it mean that you wanna like regularly, if you feel one coming on, if you have to like leave the room or not, or just do it in front of them? I think it totally depends on you and your partner. But I definitely feel like nobody should be fart shaming anybody. You can always break the ice to start the conversation if you feel the need.
Or the pressure.
Or the pressure. We've talked about a lot of different issues today. So one thing I really like to do to kind of realign ourselves with our higher selves and the love and wisdom within us is to clear out some of the energy. And I feel like sage is so good for that.
Ooh.
Do you ever burn sage?
Sometimes.
I'm like addicted to this. For everybody going through it, you're not alone. We're all in this together, right?
Yes.
Totally.